Just get it done. Driver's just the fastest way to the airport.
Yes, sir.
Daddy, you're always so stressed when we have to do it.
Yeah, well, nothing ever works, though.
Thank you.
Walter, quick, quick.
It is the fault of the people, and that was stealing. They deserve it. Only God knows how the fire came about.
Oh my God. It was great stuff. I mean, great stuff. But we need more. Right on it, on everything.
There's never enough. The pain, the feeling, everything about this. We'll get it all. The real healing. I have more than health problems.
We are outside of the town hall in Warri, Nigeria's Delta State, to witness a meeting between members of the Niger Delta's oil interests and its local communities. Nigeria is the fifth largest producer of oil in the world. It is also home to a population of over 100 million people living on less than $4 a day.
Visitors in our midst. Our people say the owl never flies by sunlight unless it is pursued by an aggrieved hunter.
Okay.
In this case, who is the owl or who is the aggrieved hunter? That is at your understanding and discretion.
We have come here not only to offer you condolence, but to offer you and your community compensation for your irreplaceable loss. We are now in a situation which requires critical decisions. Do we compensate each family for their loss, or do we compensate the entire community?
be given to us individually.
Let that be given to the community. We can use it for infrastructure. Is there no man to speak for your family?
I wish the fire had kept them alive. Besides, do men feel pain differently from women?
This is a matter for women.
Then you will have to regard me as a man. Good show. Good show you put up here. Another wonderful way of pitching family against family. Or would I say, man against man. You come here and retain yourselves from the spoils of our land. In the process, wiping out families and generations. Here to keep the fire burning. Give the people a rest, and then we rely on you. What they do is give us sickness and then treat us. They make us hungry and then feed us. They kill our loved ones and then offer us money for burials. Can you not see that bad? It is high time you start to think more of the people other than your selfish fat pockets, as well as that of your goons and cohorts. If you do not change your ways, the people you're new face in the debate over the Niger Delta. Are you here to ask the people to rise? I'm not a new face, not just one of the faces. I must mention, I'm one of the beneficiaries of Western Oral Scholarships. As someone with the benefit of a Western education, have you come home to represent the people? No, I'm not trained to upset the people. Excuse me? I'm sorry, I didn't get a chance to introduce myself.
I've been covering the Delta for almost 3 years now, and I have never met somebody who sees things as clearly as you have. I think your voice can make a real difference here.
Do you think the men will let you speak? I'm not here to speak for the people. All I want is what's right for me and my people.
Who is she?
One of the beneficiaries of our scholarship program.
Oh, well. No good deed ever goes unpunished, then.
It's good PR, sir.
I couldn't care about that, okay? We have a corrupt military government breathing down our goddamn necks. The last thing we need is a body count next to our logo. Take care of it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. These are your people, okay? Talk to me. What are we going to do here?
The villagers, they're going to be a problem. They're asking for compensation, individual payments and losses. But we can handle them through the elders.
It didn't seem like that yesterday.
They're in Abuja right now. And they want to meet.
Okay, how much are we talking about?
Well, if we...
May I suggest 500,000, sir?
500,000? Is that for the individual or for compensation for the entire community?
Listen, I don't care if you give it to the elders, if you throw it up in the air. Just make it go away.
Yes, sir.
Gideon, find this girl. Maybe I can you offer her anything. We need her on our side before this thing blows up. It's out of control.
Yeah, suggesting $500,000.
$500,000.
How do we get this money? We really need to tell how much we're going to give to another white man. He wants a cut. Let's give the white man $100,000. Okay. What about yourself?
I suggest you give $50,000.
Well, okay. Okay, but you have to excuse me while I make arrangements for the money.
God bless you. Thank you.
We are expecting $350,000. There are four of us here. I suggest we share $50,000 each.
Yes.
And we use the rest for the hospital project.
I really do appreciate this, but I must decline your offer. If I wanted a lucrative job, I would have stayed back in the U.S. My desire to be here is for the people.
This is Nigeria, I believe. Think like a Nigerian.
Am I supposed to collect a bribe to be Nigerian?
This is not a bribe. It is just the company's way of saying we appreciate your efforts.
What efforts? Efforts that could keep my family alive.
That was nobody's fault.
So, have you come here to offer another bribe to me?
No, I didn't come here to debate with you guys, man.
No, don't do it.
Come on, man. What happened was it's nobody's fault.
It is always our fault.
Wait.
So you don't touch America, you won't die.
Who
fought
it?
Now when you come, man.
You fix all this thing, man.
Yes,
any chance preparing to go and join that lunacy?
Is that what you call it? Lunacy? For once, our people are able to bond in a peaceful way, and you call it lunacy?
Yes!
All because the men are not involved.
Husana!
Yes?
You cannot live in this house!
And who will stop me? You are not army. Don't blame me for your inadequacies and weakness. Since the men have decided to take bribe to enrich themselves, the women will take matters into their hands.
Okay. Husana,
yes?
If you leave, it is over. And don't expect to come back to this house.
In case you forgot, my mother left me this house. It is my house. You may as well do me the favor of moving out before I get back.
Husana!
Useless man. And make sure you leave everything I bought, which will include what you are wearing. Useless man.
Husana!
How did I get here?
My sister is very popular amongst the women.
Yes, she is. Why don't you join us this time?
I don't believe in doing these things with protests. I want to fight. I want to make life unbearable for them.
Something happens to you. Suppose you get killed.
But then at least I died fighting for something I believe in, fighting for my land. Anyway, no one will miss me.
Husana, we'll miss you. I will miss you. Join us this one time.
They can protest us, but
yes, fight.
That's what we're doing. None of the women do this on their own. We'll fight for our own land. What are we fighting for?
Freedom!
Any weapons?
Thank you.
No, thank you. Thank you.
You wouldn't make that.
Just in case.
Destroy our village. Rape our women. Destroy our families. It was A. This is not the way.
Where are you headed for?
Abuja.
Why?
Why? I believe it's a business wild camp.
Our intelligence reports say a group of people are on their way to try to overthrow the government.
And those people are us, in 10 buses, to overthrow a military government. Wow.
We will have to do a body search on everyone.
No, I'm surprised they sent you, Tamino.
You know him?
Mm-hmm. He's my cousin. We were supposed to join the force together, but I suppose I wasn't good enough. Now they sent him to stop us. They sent our own to stop us.
Can you not see what they're doing?
I'm only doing my job. I am a sworn officer of the Nigerian police force. My tribal locality is only secondary to my duty.
What is your duty? What is your duty?
Protecting the citizens of Nigeria.
We are citizens of Nigeria too.
Uh-huh.
And law abiding.
Then you should have no protest to the search.
You know, you are a disgrace to your people. You are a disgrace.
Please turn around and go back. My hands are tied, Dede. You can't be found with any weapons.
No. I want you to arrest me. I want your government to achieve their aim. I want you to arrest me now.
These men are here to monitor me. I am being set up.
But then leave the force now.
I cannot do that. My men are close to fire.
What is this? What are you doing?
My job.
We are to conduct a search on everyone in all the buses. You have to throw your hands in the air. So you're going to do this?
I warned you. Now it's too late.
Your hands in the air!
You are crazy! You are crazy!
Do not stop this! Stop this, Osana! Do not stop this! Do not stop this! Do not stop this! Do not stop this! Do not stop this!
Reported that on the 15th of January this year, you did give instructions to your men to vandalize the facilities of Western Norway.
I did not give any of such orders.
Excuse me if I do not understand. But you invited them to come along with you to Abuja.
I did ask for company.
For what, if I may ask?
A mass rally.
Aha! A mass rally! Yes.
It was meant to be a peaceful protest. The government for the degradation of our land and our people by oil companies.
17 guns were found in the possession of your men. Were you aware that those men were carrying guns? I ask you again. Were you aware that those men were carrying guns?
I only discovered when we were about to leave.
And you let them go with them?
I didn't think much of it.
You and your men were planning not only to terrorize the oil companies, but also against the government. You were planning to overthrow the federal government. You are in serious trouble. Crime of treasonable felony. It's punishable in this country only by death. You people are very lucky people. And you have only one group of people to be grateful to. The Western Oil Company. You may now all go. Violence is the only language they understand. You men are with me.
There was nothing I could do.
I know.
Thank you.
What the government and the oil companies want is a war, and we will give it to them.
Violence never pays. There are better ways of sending a message across. Protest. We can march down the streets of Lagos and Abuja. We can make the world hear our cries.
The world is in business. Kill us.
Look, this is Nigeria again. We have a military government. Huh? Protest, they don't work. Uh-huh. Just push me in the line of fire. Uh-huh. I would rather die fighting.
Mm-hmm.
Fighting. I'm walking from Lagos to Abuja. Uh-huh. We don't go green.
How much are we talking about here? We can't be sponsoring rebels.
Okay, they're not rebels, they're people. And the best thing I think we can do as people is to
support. No, I hear you. I understand that.
But we cover the news and leave
the help work to the UN. We can't be financing a protest. We would look like instigators.
We are the people.
There forever, the girl. She's going to be a problem, sir.
How so?
Well, she's winning the people over and she won't accept anything from us.
What Nigerian doesn't accept a bribe?
This one, sir.
I thought you said you had it all covered with the elders.
Well,
I'll tell you what, we've tried the high road. Now we're going to go low.
Yes, sir.
I want a meeting with the head of state.
Sir, the rebels have just captured two of our staff.
American?
I'm afraid so. We paid $2 million. We keep paying and paying. For what? Well, why don't we get the military to clean it up?
No. That will be a PR disaster. Look, what we need is the girl. She knows who we are. She knows where they are.
Abiri? After what happened?
Not a chance.
I know my people. I know Abiri. It will cost a little more, but that's what we need.
How much?
$500,000.
Whatever it takes, do it. And you bring Iberia to us.
It's done. And everybody will come back alive.
Good.
Please sit.
Thank you. But I'd rather remain standing.
Thomas.
I know who you are.
I'm sorry about what happened to you.
You're sorry? That's good to know. I'll tell you since then.
Listen, I'm a corporate entity. I don't tell the military where to go. I don't tell them what to do.
It was a peaceful protest.
It was uninvited, and it was on our premises. Two of my men were kidnapped. Okay, they're being held for $2 million ransom, or they're going to be killed.
What has that got to do with me?
Because I need you to help negotiate and find out who did this.
Is that my new job offer?
Listen, if we don't sort this thing out, the military's going to move in, your people are going to get killed, my people are going to get killed. We need to do what we can do to avoid all this carnage. I need your help.
What you have turned into? A mere criminal? What has become of you, Dede?
I have become who the government has made me be.
Those men have families like we do.
Do we have families?
No! No. No.
Do we have families?
No.
Do we have families?
No. You must let them go.
Why? Because you say so?
Because it's the right thing to do.
This is no longer about me. This is about all of us. These men have suffered losses, some even greater than yours and mine. This has become a movement for us. This is not about the money. It's about our land!
Yes!
And it's the
truth of pain. Do not be surprised. My people are my people. I would rather die on the right side.
What have they done to you? Stay here and fight with us.
I cannot. People back home need me.
I need you too.
Things are different. I'm getting really tired.
Then come here and be with me. Stay here with me.
I don't want to be a fugitive all my life. I don't want to be running. I want what every other woman wants. I want love, family, children.
I can give you that.
DJ.
Keep me going. This struggle is you.
Please don't say that.
With you, I feel like I can conquer the whole world.
Thank you.
know you don't like me, okay? And I know all about you, and you know nothing about me.
The little I know about you is enough.
I was actually born in Nigeria. My father used to run a tin mine in Kaduna.
The more reason you should care about this country. Your company produces more than half the oil in Nigeria, and it is your money that keeps the military in power.
My company has no say in who runs this country. The Bureau. I want you to end all of this. You tell your people, let us sit down, let us address all these issues. We want peace, and we're ready to listen.
And what gives you the impression those men are going to listen to me?
No. They'll listen to you. All you need to do is convince one person, and the rest will listen to you.
Word has come, not only from the oil companies on our land, but also from the federal government. They want to extend an arm of peace. And they are willing to forgive us all our crimes?
They have requested that you lay your arms.
Request or demand?
At the moment, request.
I know these people. I have worked with them. The government will never guarantee anything with rebels.
We are not rebels. No, we are not rebels. We are members of the struggle.
I suggest we decline the offer.
Before you consider the option, they have asked for dialogue. This is an opportunity for you to be free. A chance for you to return to your family.
What family? This is my family. No!
Give peace a chance. Give dialogue a chance.
Are you armed? No, of course not. We had an agreement. Just checking.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
You gave your word. The government gave your word.
We will keep our word. What we doubt is if they will keep theirs.
Beg your pardon?
All we want to do is search them to make sure that they keep their word. And you brought 20 of your people to search 5 of us. Precautionary.
Hey, look. We can handle this. They're not armed. Round one, okay? I can talk to them. Hey, round one, the Delta man. Round one. Look, just let them do what they want to do. It's okay. And you know, we can handle this thing. Just a search.
We want dialogue! Some of your men with us too!
We are looking for so much for giving your word, eh?
Please, what are you doing?
These men were not to be trusted, so don't you trust with us!
How do you know you?
But they were not to be trusted!
Alex, please, put your guns down!
I order you put your guns
we
down!
We don't want to put them there! Please tell your men to put their arms down. I can handle the situation, I beg you, please.
Your men are not to be trusted.
Please trust me.
We are military men, and we cannot put down our weapons. Ask your men to put down their weapons!
Only chance at peace. If it doesn't work now, it may never. I beg you in the name of God.
If you do not drop your weapons, my men will shoot.
No.
I have another gun with me.
This was not meant to happen this way.
So you had a plan?
No. No. You had another plan.
Just allow us to leave this way, and we'll talk another day.
That is not possible.
Because my orders are to bring you in.
Hey, let's decide how you want to bring us in. Dead or alive?
David, please don't do this. Please.
Too many of our people have died. Too many have sacrificed. If I have to die, I want to die being on the right side. They are on the wrong side.
Sit up and watch the sky. did it.
They have killed our brothers, our sisters, our fathers, our mothers, even our children. For what they cannot kill is our spirits. For every time they put a knife through us, we only get stronger. So this time, for Didi, we will be strong. For Didi!
To be a change.
We did not send them to the creeks as rebels.
But our actions did.
So now you are blaming us for all the happenings?
Things could have been different if we had given all the money to the community. I'm going to give back my share to the people. You all should consider doing the same. I do not want blood on my hands.
Dead this morning. I know they did it.
My father told me last night that he had blood money on his hands. And shortly after, his friends came and they drank all night. And after they left, he went to bed and this morning, he was dead. You know what else? I found the money under his bed. $50,000.
He cannot let this crime pass us by.
No.
The perpetrators of this crime must be brought to face justice.
Yes, forgive me, it wasn't my idea, it was Chief Cook that put us to it.
That is why you killed my father.
No, I didn't kill your father.
Liar!
But it was Chief Cook and Chief Cook that poisoned his drink.
What the hell?
Please tell me. Please.
Bring him. Where did he go to?
He went to Abuja.
He shall be made to pay for his crimes.
I have children like you.
You should have thought about that before accepting money from Western Horn.
First, get them tight.
and face the law.
What law? The law that cannot protect my father.
You're not kill us.
Maybe yesterday. But my father's lifeless body lies in his room, all because of these criminals.
But we cannot do this.
You do not have to get involved.
I'm on your side. The world sees this, the world will be on your side too. Let's come.
You can come in.
Thank you. Abide, can you tell me what I'm seeing?
Our elders have failed us again. They collected a bribe from Western Oil and murdered Chief Kadibia because he wanted out.
Do you have it?
Yes, I do. $50,000 in cash.
What will happen with the chiefs now?
We will have to look and face the law.
As I drove up, I was hearing a chant. Can you tell me what those words mean?
The people say they can't take this anymore.
Yes! One final question. Do you trust the courts to do?
A vocal crowd of Abide supporters has been gathered here since the early hours.
Within Warri Judicial Division, conspired with one another to commit murder, punishable by Section 319, Subsection 1 of the Criminal Code, Part 48, Volume 2, Laws of the Defunct Bendel State, 1976, as applicable in Delta State. Peter Gadibia, do you understand the charges read against you?
I do, my lord.
How do you plead?
Not guilty.
He pleads not guilty, my lord. Eloho Akobasa, do you understand the charges read against you?
I do, my lord.
How do you plead?
Not guilty.
She pleads not guilty, my lord. Ebere Perema, do you understand the charges read against you?
I do, my lord.
How do you plead?
Guilty.
Order in this court. Do you understand the charges against you?
Yes, my lord. I plead guilty. I see where this is going, so I'd rather not waste my time, as well as out of the court. My lord, can this court graciously grant us recess, so as to enable the defense team to have a word with our client?
What are you doing?
They want us dead. They will hang us.
Where's the part of you that fought so hard?
There's one thing I learned from reading about you. It's the never-say-die attitude.
This is a kangaroo court.
And the sitting judge has as much of the noose around his neck as I will.
Yes, but there may be hope. You of all people should understand that.
Understand what? Understand the fact that I'm about to be hanged to these people? No, I will not understand that.
I'm gonna tell you that it's gonna be okay.
They're ready to negotiate, but they need a scapegoat. They want you free.
In return for what?
You will have to indict some of your people.
You want me to go out there and put the blame on someone else?
Why not? Put the blame on Tricky Petrus as a crime.
But I didn't see whoever did it.
But Peter, he had motive. He wanted revenge on his father.
Yes. But I didn't see him do it.
You need to decide what you saw and what you didn't see. If he had listened to you, this would not have happened. You need to go out there and say exactly that. Tell them the truth. Tell them how you warned them. So the guilty are punished. You live.
I swear to Almighty God.
I swear to Almighty God.
That the evidence I shall give in this case.
That the evidence I shall give in this case.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
Nothing but the truth.
Nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Miss Ebiere Berima, can you tell this court what happened on June 4th?
I killed the men. Excuse me? I poured petrol all over the car and burnt them to death. These people, they tried to stop me, but I wouldn't let them. I killed the men, and I did it alone. I killed them because they caused the circumstance that led to the death of my daddy.
Guilty of murder on all counts. You shall be taken from here to a place of execution. You shall hang by the neck until you are dead. May God have mercy on your soul.
Feel of your baby?
What about the people, goddammit? What about the girl?
This happens to be an international crisis. Asshole. Executing her would be a mistake. I know that now. Hey, this just isn't about me. Hello? Hello?
We're in on the site.
No one's listening to me.
Do whatever you want with me. Don't hurt her.
Stay back. I say, Waka.
Please, stop.
I can't do anything. Hey, hey, listen to me. I'm sorry. What happened to your families? I'm sorry. What happened to you? What happened to all of you?
And steal yourself.
No more talking. That's it.
Released a statement to the press that Edgar Reyes has been freed. There's an American life at stake, a very important life. We'll do everything to keep him alive.
When last count, there was more than one life involved.
You mean armed terrorists?
They're people.
They're people with AKs and explosives rigged to tankers.
If we do this, it can result in a backlash of terrorist acts on America. Then what? Shouldn't we be focused on keeping Edgar Reyes alive? Sir, all we have to do is contact the Nigerian government.
No, it is inappropriate for us to meddle in a judicial decision of a foreign government. The United States will not condone acts of terrorism on American soil.
Thank you.
Thank you.